Welcome to the IDS podcast in skin reactions of new melanoma drugs. New melanoma drugs include BRAF, MEK inhibitors and their combinations, as well as the immune checkpoint inhibitors, including ipilimumab, nivolumab and pembrolizumab. The adverse events from BRAF inhibitors in the skin can be roughly divided into neoplastic and non-neoplastic skin toxicities. Cutaneous squamous cell carcinomas, verrucal keratosis, new primary melanomas and nephite changes belong to the group of the neoplastic cutaneous adverse events. Even though the precise pathogenesis has not been completely elucidated, it seems that they appear as a result of paradoxical activation of the MAP kinase pathway by BRAF inhibition in BRAF wild-type cells. The vast majority of squamous cell carcinomas are well-differentiated, mostly of keratoacanthoma type. They are more common among patients receiving vemurafenib and less common in those receiving the combinations with MEK inhibitors. They usually present as crateriform, pink papule or nodule with a central keratinous or hemorrhagic mass. This is a typical example of a small squamous cell carcinoma arising in a patient receiving vemurafenib. Dermoscopy is extremely useful in early recognition of these lesions, since it highlights the typical crateriform morphology and the herpin vessels at the periphery of the lesion. Our second patient has two lesions on his trunk. With the use of our dermatoscope, we can easily diagnose the squamous cell carcinoma on the left and the verrucal keratosis on the right. Under the term verrucal keratosis, we describe lesions consisting of small, hyperkeratotic papules that resemble viral warts, actinic keratosis, or small keratoacanthomas, and are quite common in BRAF inhibitors. These lesions display moderate atypia in the basal cell layer, indicating that they may represent precursors of squamous cell carcinomas. Apart from keratinizing tumors, BRAF inhibitors may result in new appearance and relevant modifications of nevi. The changes may include involution or evolution with modifications in size or in pigmentation. This is an early phenomenon that usually happens within the first 6 months of treatment. Digital dermoscopy is extremely useful in follow-up and early detection of any suspicious change. With digital monitoring during treatment with BRAF inhibitors, we may also discover new melanomas. The majority of them arise in a pre-existing nevus, like in this case, or in this case, and in this case. Dahl et al. First described this phenomenon, and during the next years, many other publications reporting new melanomas in individuals treated with BRAF inhibitors came in light. However, whether these new melanomas represent real melanomas or changing pre-existing nevi that histopathologically mimic melanomas due to drug-induced activation remains controversial. In any case, digital total body photography and digital dermoscopy is mandatory to detect and surgically excise any suspicious lesion. If a new melanoma is confirmed, a wide excision should be considered depending on the patient's status and the type of melanoma. There is a long list of non-neoplastic cutaneous toxicities associated to BRAF inhibitors with photosensitivity, acantholytic dermatosis, palmoplantar erythrodysesthesia and xerosis being the most common. Photosensitivity is a UVA-dependent phototoxicity, which is much more common with vemurafenib compared to dabrafenib. In these patients, there is also an increased risk for radiodermatitis. The sunburn develops within minutes of sun exposure and involves the sun-exposed areas. The patient should be advised to avoid the sun and to use sun-protecting clothes and sunscreens. Another very characteristic lesion that we may see in the course of BRAF inhibitors is the acantholytic dyskeratoma. It appears as a small eroded and pruritic papule of the skin. Dermoscopically, it displays a central stellate erosion on a reddish background, as seen in these two clinical examples. Palmoplantar erythrodysesthesia is more common in multi-kinase inhibitors. Here you can see a typical example of this toxicity in a 22-year-old female patient. MEK inhibitors are usually prescribed in combination with BRAF inhibitors. The most common toxicity with their use as monotherapy includes an eczematoid rash and acneiform dermatitis. Currently, the most popular treatment is the combination of BRAF and MEK inhibitors. The combination is less toxic in any aspect, with papulopustular eruption being the most common. In regards with the immune checkpoint inhibitors, cutaneous reactions appear as the most prevalent, and it seems that their occurrence may be correlated with a better therapeutic response. Here is the list with the most common skin toxicities associated to immunotherapy. The maculopapular rash starts after 2 to 4 weeks. It is highly pruritic, but hopefully it is usually self-limited and easily manageable. Vitiligo is mainly seen in melanoma patients under treatment with pembrolizumab and nivolumab. In this slide, we see a 75-year-old individual under treatment with nivolumab for metastatic melanoma that developed both vitiligo and bullous pemphigoid. Lichenoid reactions, as in this individual, particularly happen with anti-PD-1 and anti-PD-L1 agents. Dermoscopy may prove extremely useful in accurate diagnosis of lichenoid reactions, since it highlights the pathognomonic intersecting white lines, the so-called Wickham's striae, on the surface of the lesions. De novo psoriasis, or exacerbation of psoriasis and psoriatic arthritis, is a well-established toxicity. In this slide, we see a patient with pustular psoriasis, though all the clinical types of psoriasis may be seen during immunotherapy. Other sites of involvement in the same patient who additionally developed vitiligo on his scalp. Patients under treatment with anti-PD-1 and anti-PD-L1 are in a higher risk of development or worsening of bullous pemphigoid. Here is a clinical example of a female patient with metastatic melanoma who developed bullous pemphigoid during treatment with nivolumab. The next case is a lady with both vitiligo and bullous pemphigoid that she had to stop immunotherapy due to the severity of bullous pemphigoid. The complete list of skin toxicities related to immunotherapy can be found in this table. In red are the most dangerous drug reactions, however, are rarely seen in correlation with these agents. Our goal with new melanoma drugs is to prolong survival with minimal impairment of patients' quality of life. As dermatologists, we should take good care of drug-related adverse events to ensure that our patients derive the optimal benefit from their therapy. Thank you for attending this podcast. We welcome you to visit all the podcasts provided by the IDS.